Details on what could be a huge day in court tomorrow. Levi Chavez will reveal whether he is taking the stand. Action 7 reporter Lawrence Kalik has that, plus what happened today.
The only witness after Samantha Wheeler that I may call is the defendant Levi Chavez.
In less than 12 hours, we'll know if Levi Chavez is going to take the stand. He's the former APD officer on trial, accused of shooting his wife Tara as she lay in their bed.
Mr. Chavez has implored me to ask the court if we could have the evening so that he could make up his mind as to whether he wants to take the stand.
Tuesday, the defense brought two witnesses to the stand. One was Samantha Wheeler for the second time in this trial. They wanted Tara's friend to clarify again what she told investigators about a gun being kept at the Chavez home.
You did tell Office Aaron Jones that Levi had left her a gun in the house?
Yes.
Did you specifically tell Aaron Jones that it was in Levi's top drawer?
Yes.
The prosecution fired back.
Did you ever see that gun?
No.
Did you have any way of believing or knowing whether that gun was still in the house when she died?
No.
That was from a previous conversation.
Months before.
Earlier on the stand, the other witness, a forensic pathologist, Dr. Charles Wetley, who has once before this been a part of a trial in which a cop allegedly staged his wife's killing to look like a suicide. The Chavez case, Wetley says, is different.
As a forensic pathologist, in reviewing all of the materials in connection with this case, did you find any evidence that indicated that this was a staged or a fake suicide?
No. Both autopsy and scene photographs did not indicate the presence of any type of struggle at all.
But the prosecution then asked Wetley about two other witnesses who failed to prove the gun's magazine could unseat itself if a person shoots themselves.
So would either of those affect your opinion today that those would not be consistent with suicide?
No, I'd say we have to figure out how the magazine was released, if in fact it was released.
And that's what the jury's here for today.
A jury that could begin deliberations as early as Wednesday. Lawrence Kalik, KOAT Action 7 News.
The prosecution says it has no plans for rebuttal witnesses, but that could, of course, always change.